So hi guys, in this video I'm going to talk about a software called Flask and how it can enhance your Python and your web application. So Flask is basically a micro web framework which allows you to integrate your web applications onto Python. Alright, so basically whatever you do in Python, right, it could be a machine learning model, it could be a simple program, it could be a simple Python game, can be now deployed onto your web application. So now I'm going to show you a web application which I created using Flask, which gives you an overall idea of what all you can actually accomplish with Flask, right? So I created a website for forest authorities and citizens to report crimes, and I integrated a machine learning model onto that, right? So basically you have two options to enter into your website. It could be an authority, it could be a citizen, right? So let me show you the dashboard for a citizen in this application. So say I'm a citizen and I registered. I've disabled the name and password for right now. And this is how the website looks like. You'll have an option to report suspicious activities. You can check the status of your report and you'll have a notice board as well, right? So if I click on report suspicious activity, I can go onto this form and enter name, telephone and whatever incident that I want to report and submit it, which will directly go onto the database that I've created using MongoDB. And you can check the status of your report. Right, I've submitted some reports before and it can show the status resolved or unresolved, which the authorities can manipulate in the database. Alright, so I'll show you how the authorities dashboard looks like. Instead of a citizen, if an authority is logging onto your website, right, he'll obviously have a username and a password, which I have disabled for now. So here's how the dashboard for him looks like. Right, they can check all the crime reports that happened that day, which will be sorted based on the incident type, right? Is it a forest cutting, is it poaching of animals, whatever, and the status of the crime report. Next, they'll have a machine learning model which predicts crime in any region, right? So I'll show you how this model looks like. So basically you have to enter any area, say some forest, and what type of crime are you looking for? Is it hunting, trading, selling, illegal transportation? And you have to enter your month, right? Which month are you checking for? So this will tell you what's the probability or how many incidents are likely to take place in this month and of this incident, right? So you simply click on predict probability and you get what are the predicted number of crimes in this region, right? So this is a machine learning model which I have deployed onto my web application. This is something that you can do. And just to make analysis better, you have an option to check it on map, where I've embedded Google Maps on this web application. So this is an all-round web application that is going to teach you everything, right? You have database management, you have machine learning models integrated, you have Google Maps embedded onto your application, and all of this is done in Flask, right? So now I'm going to show you how you can create a basic application using Flask. So I'm working on PyCharm Professional right now because it's very easy to create Flask application. You just have to go to File, click on New Project and click on Flask, right? And you have to press Create and this is what gets opened up. This program gets opened up. If you're using Python ideally, I've given a link for the documentation to install Flask on that in the description. But I personally find PyCharm very better for Flask. So I'm going to run you through the code. So we start off by importing the Flask class onto your project. In the next line, we're creating an instance of your class. We're creating an object and giving it the name app. And when we are initializing the class, we're giving the attribute as name, which is basically the name of your application. So your web application will know where to look for all the project files, right? So it creates an instance of your class in this line. So the next three lines is how you create applications, right? You have to define a function which returns something, in this case a string which says hello world. And on the top you have to write which URL is going to trigger this function, right? So when the URL is just a slash, which is by default, this function is going to get triggered. Now to run this application, we simply write app.run. And if I press on run, this should work. So Flask has basically created a local server on your laptop, which is present at this URL, right? So when I click on this, my hello world function should run. So if I click this, yeah, it says hello world, right? So that was how you create a basic application. So that was for this video, guys. In my further tutorials, I'm going to teach you how to import web pages, and finally how to deploy a machine learning model or any Python program onto your web application. So if you did like this video, do like, share and subscribe. And if there's anything else that you want to see, do leave that in the comments. And yeah, thank you for watching.